Let us consider the user enters the value of n as 3, and we are supposed to print the numbers from 1 to 3 in your horizontal structure. So how can we do that? So first of all, I'll take the variable n, and let me generate a message for the user: enter the value of n. Right. After that, I need to read the value of this n. So I'll say n assigns. Using the next int method, I'm going to read the value of n. Once this is done, now the question is, how can we print this in horizontal structure? So definitely there is repetition required here. So for that, I'm going to use for loop. So for int, I will start from 1, and the condition here, I less than or equal to n, and I will increase by one step every time. So I'll write here I compound assignment plus assigns 1. You can even use the increment operator, that is I plus plus. So it is totally up to you what you like to use. Right. Now if I write here, let us say system.out.print, this print, right, system.out.print, and if I write I, and if I attach one space, so let us observe what is the output of this one. So you know that how this print statement works, right? This print method, it will just print the data as it is without supplying any new line, right? Now let me enter the value of n. Let me enter here 3. So if you observe here, these numbers 1, 2, 3 are printed horizontally, right? So this is called your horizontal printing. So when you are printing the numbers in horizontal structure, the printing is done from in the order of left to right. So please remember, when you are printing the data in a row, this is a row, right? This is a row, first row. So whenever you are printing something in a horizontal structure, the printing is done from left to right. Please remember this. And this print statement, what it does, this print method just prints the value of I with space. So if you observe here, 1 space and then 2 space, and after that again 3 space is printed. If I remove this space and only print the value of I, let me print only the value of I itself every time. So if I enter n as 3, so it prints 1, 2, 3 together without any space, right? This is your horizontal printing. Now the question is that if I want to print these numbers vertically, then there are two options for that. So we can use this print line, that is a print ln. That means first print the data and then supply a new line. So if I run this now, if I run this and let me enter the value of n as, let's say, 4. So it prints 1, 2, 3, 4 in a vertical structure. That means if you want to print something vertically, so in that case you can use the print ln method. Or the other option is that if you are still using print method, so what you can do with this variable I, you can write something like this, slash n. So this is your new line character. What is the meaning of new line character? If I hit enter, I'm just coming into this new line, right? That means after hitting enter, whatever character you obtain, that's your new line character, right? So instead of using print ln, if I use print and along with the data, if I use slash n here, then it is going to work in the similar way. So if I enter, let us say 3 here, you see that you got all the numbers in a vertical structure. So while printing the data vertically, the printing is done in this order, that is top to bottom. So please remember one thing: whenever you are printing the data vertically, the order of printing is from top to bottom. This is the first thing. And here the other thing is that when you are printing in your horizontal structure, the printing is done from left to right. Fine. Now let us say if I give here single space, then after every digit or after every number, single space will be obtained, right, in the output. So let me enter 5 here. So you can see clearly that there is only single space. But what if I want large amount of space? So consider two characters, let's say A and B, right? Between this A and B, if I want little large amount of space, if you observe the tab key on your keyboard, and if you hit that tab, you will observe that a large amount of space will be pushed between these two characters, right? So in order to print that tab character, within this double quotes you can write slash t. So this slash t is used for printing tab character. So let me run this program again, and let me enter a value of n. So let me enter 3. So if you observe, the numbers 1, 2, 3 are printed. But what is happening? After printing the value I every time, this slash t is printed. And once you come out of the loop, you can print anything that you like. So system.out.println. If I write this method as it is, that open and close parenthesis, this will by default print a new line, right? So if you do not supply anything within this parenthesis, it will just print a new line. So let me enter 6 here, or let me enter 3. So if you observe here, this 1, 2, 3 is printed in your horizontal structure. After that, one new line is printed. Why? When this loop condition became right, this condition became false, in that case we came to this line number 17, and when this line number 17 got executed, here one new line is printed, right? So in this video we learnt about that, how can we print the data in a horizontal structure as well as in vertical structure. I hope this is clear, right? So horizontally we print in left to right order, and vertically the printing is done from top to bottom order. So this should be very clear in mind, and I hope the concept of slash n and slash t is clear.